I think we've got time for a couple of questions. Anything at all? Not geography. Who's got the first question? Of course, you have the first question.
Of course I have the first question. What is the state of GROWS?
Ah, an interesting, okay, so he asks, what is the state of GROWS? GROWS, or the GROWS method, was this initiative I'd started a couple years ago with my good friend Jared Richardson. And the idea was, back in 08, I wrote a book called Pragmatic Thinking and Learning. And that looked at sort of cognitive and neuroscience ideas of how, what can we do to learn better? Because there were a bunch of books out there like, you know, mind hacks and these sorts of ideas that I was all excited when they came out. It's like, oh, this is, I can't wait to dig into this book and see what it says. And they were garbage. They were all, here's how to memorize a list of 100 numbers. I don't need to memorize a list of 100 numbers, thank you very much. No, here's a brand new language, here's Rust, here's Elm, here's whatever. I need to learn this thing in like 2 days. Tell me how to do that. Now I'm interested. But that wasn't there. So I spent a couple years doing some research and writing and found all these really interesting things about our own cognitive biases, how we learn, how our cognitive biases affect things like agile adoption, why that doesn't work, why we are desperate for estimates even when we know they're crap, all these sorts of things. I thought, you know, that and institutionalizing learning, you know, the sort of corporate L&D departments are usually garbage too, right? They send you off to the sheep dip training once a year and you don't really get much out of it. We could do so much better. So I wanted to marry the ideas of true agile, not we use Jira and half of Scrum badly, but actual agile ideas and these sort of learning and cognitive concepts and make a new methodology out of that. And Jared and I had started and had gotten a ways down that road when he passed away suddenly in 2016. And that kind of just, that was the end of that. I stopped working on it for a while because it was just, you know, that was just too hard. Until this last year, till end of 2018, start of 2019, two of Jared's other friends got together with me and we've brought it back as a functioning thing again. And we've been doing workshops helping to teach executives the importance of the actual agile ideas. You know, exposing them to things like Kinevin diagrams and Wardley maps and, you know, those sorts of things, the actual ways of looking at systems thinking instead of linear thinking and all the linear traps that we tend to fall into and those sorts of issues. So we've been doing that, you know, sort of on the quiet, on the side. We're working on a book on it that'll be out someday. I'll make no promises there. But we are giving workshops on that, and they've been going remarkably well. I've been very heartened by that. So it's one of those things where you can describe something to somebody, and they can read about it, and yeah, that's all fine. But if you do a particular exercise with them where they actually get to experience it, all of a sudden it's like, oh, I get it now. So I've literally had executives who are like, oh, yes, we're iterative and incremental, and they didn't know what that. They could have said we were, you know, bologna and cheese. They had no idea what that meant. And then we lead them through this exercise, and they're like, oh, that's what y'all meant. I got it now. So there is hope on the horizon. It's just need more hours in the day. But thanks for asking.